This is 3D organ printing by Darren McNeil and Matthew Marin. So to start off, 3D organ printing is a way to artificially replace organs by way of 3D printing. 3D organ printing is not possible yet, but scientists are working across several laboratories to print tissues as a step closer to actually performing 3D organ printing. So for the history, the concept of 3D printing dates back to the 1980s, where the first development began. In about the 2000s, 3D printing gained a lot of media visibility when we saw the first 3D printing working kidney. Some of the equipment used for organ printing, there's a lot of equipment when it comes to 3D printing. For example, a filtration glove box, ducted cleaning glove box, and hardwall and softwall clean rooms that can all be used for 3D organ printing as well. The history of industrial 3D printing in the 1980s. 3D printing attempts began with the development of a rapid prototyping technique. Dr. Kodama was the first to describe a layer-by-layer approach for manufacturing, stated by Hannah Bensosselen. The second technique was by a man named Carl Denkard, where he used powder grains fused together by a laser. This technique was worked on at the University of Texas. The last and third technique was a man named Scott Crump, where he filed a patent for fused deposition modeling, stated by Hannah Bensosselen. In 1992, the patent for fused deposition modeling had worked very good, where it was now being used for professional and individual use. From 1993 to 1999, 3D printing came up with several techniques, and at the same time, CAD tools for 3D printing was more developed and more used around the world. Also, the 1990s were the beginning of medical use in 3D printing for different types of medicine, opening a lot of eyes for the future of 3D printing. This picture shows a skull of a T-Rex that was designed on CAD and was 3D printed when finished. In 2000, there was a working 3D printed kidney. Obviously, it was not transplanted in anyone, but is indeed working and functioning. In 2008, there was the first 3D printed prosthetic limb, which increased media visibility greatly.
Scaffolds are created in tissue engineering by 3D printing and used as a platform which living cells could be placed and grow tissue on. Tissue engineering is the use of a combination of cells, engineering and material methods, and suitable biochemical and physicochemical factors to improve or replace biological tissue. Tissue engineering involves the use of tissue scaffold for the formation of new viable tissue. Scaffolds are very important in 3D organ printing because without them, body tissues wouldn't be able to survive the 3D printing, therefore making 3D organ printing possible. Matching the structure and softness of body tissue is crucial to the success of tissue engineering. Scaffolds have to be biocompatible, but also have to be similar to the original damaged tissue they are replacing. They are becoming used widespread amongst tissue engineers. Plastic. It is the most common material used in 3D printing. Powders, resins, metals, carbon fiber, graphites and graphene, nitrile, paper, and many more are used. 3D printing technology. Fused deposition modeling. It is the most common and inexpensive type of 3D printing. In this form of 3D printing, a thermoplastic filament is passed through a heated print head and is placed down onto the platform in a one on top of the other fashion until it is formed. Extrusion-based bioprinting. In this way of 3D printing, materials are extruded through a print head by pneumatic pressure or mechanical force. Materials are continuously placed in layer by layer until the end product is formed. Advantages of using this method include precise deposition of cells, control over the rate of cell distribution, and process speed have increased the applications at this method in fabricating living scaffolds greatly. This method is used for regeneration of bone cartilage, aortic valves, skeletal muscle, neuronal, and other tissues. Material sintering. This process used the powdered form of printing material in a reservoir and fused into a solid object either by physical, like UV laser or electron beam, or chemical binding source. This is the oldest type of 3D printing. There is no contact between printhead and printing material during this method. This procedure is the worst for 3D organ printing because of the lack of polymer resins, which are crucial for biomedical applications. Inkjet or binder jet printing. Binding liquid is dropped onto the procedured bed to combine the materials in a consecutive manner and continued until it is formed. Polyjet printing. Layers of photopolymer resin are jetted onto the build platform and are simultaneously curved using UV light. This is used for fabricating complex prints. Polyjet is widely used in the medical field because of its ability to create complex material.
Tissue and how it's involved in 3D organ printing. Scientists implanted the 3D printed ear, bone, and muscle structures into animals. The structures turned into functional tissue and also developed a system of blood vessels, stated by Wake Forest Baptist Medical Center. There are several proof in mice that had ears implanted, and months later, the ear was well maintained, and cartilage tissue, blood vessels had formed, stated by Wake Forest Baptist Medical Center. Scientists are using 3D printers in creating living body parts, such as a functional ear with skin cells and cartilage cells. Even though it's just an ear and not their main goals of hearts, livers, and kidneys, but it's putting them in the right direction. The bioprinter that is used for the ears at Wake Forest University is believed to have the capability to soon be able to implant these organs into humans. So these are the top three 3D organ printing companies. The number one 3D organ printing company is named Organavo. Organavo has successfully printed liver tissue that had actually functioned successfully for several weeks. This company has also made a fully functional human kidney tissues through its 3D printer. The second company is named Cellink, which has the goal of helping to shape the future of healthcare and eliminate animal testing, as stated on The Medical Futurist. The last company is Aspect Biosystems. This company is out of British Columbia and is recently focused on the development of 3D printed knee meniscus tissue between joints. 3D organ printing as a whole is not fully possible yet, but a possibility in the future with clear technological advances towards it. 3D organ printing would be very beneficial because it could help a large variety of people, and due to the lack of organ donations, it would help tremendously.
This would be a huge step in the medical field because so many more lives could be saved and could potentially lead to other advancements in the medical field, like maybe, per se, a brain transplant.